Hi guys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be continuing our prevention series. You know, the basic tips for the layman vehicle owner who needs to check up on a few things to make sure that the vehicle stays in good condition. Today's topic is going to be dealing with oil, and yes, I've spread out a few cans of oil that I use in some in this vehicle and in other vehicles that I have. I've got older vehicles and I've also got some newer vehicles, and this is the oil that I generally use in my vehicles. Firstly, this is not sponsored by Shell or Castrol or anybody else. This is purely just for educational purposes and to help us layman type mechanics and vehicle owners out there. The very first thing that I want to say is that oil is the lifeblood of your engine. In the engine, the actual metal parts are being separated by a very thin layer of oil, especially when it comes to the crankshaft, camshaft. Anything that rubs against one another is protected by this oil. Now, most people, when you start neglecting your services, that is when you're going to pick up a problem. And you're going to find that you're going to get various problems. The worst, of course, that being the bearings not getting enough lubrication and your vehicle ending up with a bearing knock. That is a very expensive exercise to repair, and it's really not something that you want to happen when you own a vehicle. Also, things like your cams, your camshaft, cam lifters, your pistons, piston rings, all these things are influenced by the quality and the type of oil and the actual duration for which the oil is in your engine. So that brings us to the next point. When should I change my oil? And in most cases, most manufacturers will tell you 10,000, some will say 5,000 kilometers. It's best to follow your manufacturer's instructions. And that's a very important thing. If you don't know anything about your vehicle, go on the internet, go and download yourself the vehicle specs for your vehicle. Get the right model number, the right year model, the correct model that you need to get. And then, download the spec for it. Download the manual. There are places where you can pay for a manual. Some do it free, some you have to pay for. But at the end of the day, get yourself a manual that you can actually know exactly what the manufacturer specifies for your vehicle. They will tell you exactly what oil to put in, what coolant to put in, the grade of the coolant, the grade of the oil. They'll tell you all of those things in your instruction manual. The oil will also determine, it's also a very good indicator of what's going on in your engine. So if you haven't changed your oil for a very long time, now's the time to just go out there and I'll show you, just have a look, and you'll see there's two things that you can have a look at, and that is your oil cap, which sits normally on top. In different vehicles it'll be in different places, but that's your oil cap, and then also your dipstick at the bottom, and they're normally very simple to access. And what you want to do is just take out your, loosen up your oil cap and have a look at the oil cap and what's happening underneath on this oil cap. And you want to see a clear form of oil on there, no white residue, no buildup, nothing on there. It's got to be clean and clear. If that's a condition of oil cap, then you know your oil is in good condition and your engine should be in a reasonable condition and the oil is doing its job. So that's one of the things. The second thing you can do, pull out the dipstick. Once a month, pull out that dipstick, have a look and see what's the condition of the oil. The dipstick will tell you quickly what the condition is. In this case, my oil is still reasonably clear. There's a bit of brown and black forming in it because I've driven it for some time now since the last oil change, but still reasonably clear, and it's not looking too bad. But sometimes I've seen vehicles where you take out this dipstick and it's black and it's thick, and that's really not what you want. But just think about it, inside the engine it's going to be black and thick, and it's not going to be protecting the parts. The oil actually has a lifespan, and if you go over that lifespan, you're basically going to harm your engine. So this is two things you can do. Look at that cap, look at the dipstick. if your oil is in a is in this type of condition, normally if it's just been changed, it'll be even more clear. But it mustn't be black. It can be light brown, shades of brown, but definitely not black. If it's black, please change it. The other thing that we need to look at is the oil filter. Now, also, once again, it's part of the lubrication system. So make sure that the oil and the oil filter is changed at the same time. Oil filters are not very expensive. They're usually very cheap. So there's really no excuse not to change your oil filter. Make sure that you change it regularly or at its service interval. So what oil should you use in the engine, right? So once again, I'm going to say that this is not sponsored. This video is not sponsored by Shell, Castrol. This is just basically oil brands that I like to use. And from the experience over my years working in various, working with various engines, from motorcycles to normal vehicles, it is best to use a well-known branded oil. Nothing wrong with other oil. But I prefer to use a well-branded oil like Shell or Castrol. There's normally very good brands of oil. So for this vehicle of mine, I'm using the Magnetic. That is the 10W40. And there is some way that you need to use it. So you can use it, and there's always going to be a debate about which one to use. Do you use a synthetic or do you use the normal multi-grade oil? So for me, I've just found that if you treat the Magnetic oil in a certain manner, you're going to get a very good result. I've used it for a number of years, and there's a certain way in which you need to use it. I find that with the fully synthetic oils, you're best to start with 10W40. 10W40 has got to do with the thickness of the oil. I'm not going to go into a very deep discussion about the types of oil, the grades, and also the technology inside of it. That is for another time, or you can research it yourself. But in the normal older vehicles, and when I say older, I'm talking about vehicles from 2000 up to possibly 2010, you can definitely use your 10W40. Then there's fully synthetics which you can use in your more modern vehicles. Okay, you can also use your Shell HX5 15W40, which is also very good oil. I've used it in this vehicle as well, in vehicles similar to this one. I've also used it. You can use them in older vehicles. This oil is also very good. Gives you a very good lifespan, especially when you do a lot of driving, and this one is very good for that. Then we've got the Shell the Helix HX3. Now this one is designed more for older vehicles, or also for diesel vehicles, diesel buckies. It also works very well in that. So this is just three brands of oil, and you know, if you want more technical definition about what they actually do, then you can go on the internet, you can Google it, you can find out all the technical specs. But if ever you're going to buy oil and you're going into the spare shop, you're going to get one spare shop with it. No, just use the Helix HX5s. I'm not going to tell you, no, you need Magnetic. I stood in a major retail spare shop already, where the guys were arguing really between each other what oil to use. So this is very confusing for you know, for the layman for which the series is created. And at the end of the day, the best thing is to do your own research, or speak to people who actually have used oil like this, or have got experience with using the oil, because there is certain reasons as to why it's going to be better to use the HX5, the multi-grade oil, compared to the Magnetic. It just depends on your vehicle build, your engine build. That is something that's very important. If you are running if you're going to be modifying your vehicle, then you're going to have to use a certain type of oil, because it's going to depend upon the amount of modifications you're going to do. If you're going to run a turbo, you're going to have a certain amount of boost you want to create. Then things like your crankshaft, bearings all start changing. And you know, when it comes to things like that, then that's a whole other discussion. But we're not going to focus on that. We're going to focus on the basic day-to-day layman who's driving his vehicle in the street and wants to just make sure his vehicle doesn't last another 20 years. So in terms of that, guys, this is the three oils that you can use in your vehicle. An oil change is very simple to do. It's really, really very simple. The most important thing is get the right oil, get a good quality oil filter. If you're going to pay up to 80, 90 rand for an oil filter, then you should be getting a good oil filter. Oil is quite expensive. You'll find that these brands in front of you here is very expensive. But then again, this is about how long your engine is going to last and having the best product inside the engine. Oil change is very easy to do. Basically, you're going to drain out the oil. And thereafter, you're going to take off your oil filter, make sure it's clean. You're going to inspect at the bottom. You're going to inspect your sump nut. You're going to check for any filings or metal parts inside there. And once you've done that, then you know you've ensured that your engine is actually good for the next 10,000 kilometers. This is probably the most important factor of an engine, and that is that you change your oil. Please don't neglect oil changes. You know, find the money. I know things are hard out there today, guys, for everybody, but find the money. Go and find the money. Find that 500 rand, and if you can't do it yourself, ask a family member maybe, or someone to help you, or someone to assist you. But it's not that difficult. You can do it by yourself. Just make sure you got your facts right with what oil you're using and your oil filter for your vehicle. But I can't stress enough, this is the most important part of making sure that your engine lasts a very long time. In most cases, when you open up the engine and you see inside, then you know this is neglect. You know someone hasn't changed the oil for the last 2 years, and now he wants a full service, full oil change, and that's when your problems come. Okay, guys, that is basically all I have to say at this point in time with regards to oil. I know it's a very contentious subject, oil, but remember what I said. At the end of the day, just change the oil. Make sure you do it when you have to change the oil. Make sure if you change it 5,000, you change it 5,000. If you're approaching 10,000, change it at 9,000. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or just want to make a few comments, please feel free to comment in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next video.